Yo, what up, people? It's your boy, Not Lax. This is some behind the scenes shit right now, because I have finally just got inspired to do a fresh vlog. Fresh vlog! And this vlog is actually, oh, I'm in the dark. You can't see me. Black nigga in the dark. Need some light in this guy. Check this out. Bam! Oh shit, don't watch that. I'm missing a light bulb. I think I ran out of light on a lamp upstairs, so I took it off my vlogging rig. But yeah, I'm setting up. Got my tripod, got my light, got my background light. I gotta kick this, put that on there. That comes on. I got some lights back here I'm trying to turn on too, because I want to make a vlog. We're making vlogs right now. It's one in the morning, Sunday. I guess it's Monday now. And, you know, this guy just wants to vlog about 60 months with the locs. So stay tuned. This is the new vid, Not Locs with the Vlogs. Yeah. Now, I kind of want to shoot this vlog a bit differently. Yeah, because it's been a while and my hair is a mess. It really needs to be washed right now. But more importantly, let's set up the vlogging gear. So I got my camera gear. You can see that. I'm not sure if you can see that. And this is my good camera, Canon 7D. And I'm gonna set up a little bit of a double angle here. Double angle workflow. And then I'm gonna set up a second angle with the one that I'm shooting on right now, which is the Canon Rebel T3i. And normally I'm not this elaborate when I'm making these vlogs, but I feel as though today I want to put out some of HD quality goodness, colorful, bright for you guys, right? So I'm gonna try to figure out how I'm gonna set these cameras up for this vlog, multicam. So I got my setup. I just put up the Canon 7D with a wide-angle lens in front of the lighting board, and I need one more thing, which is this. When you're making vlogs or YouTube videos, audio is always one of the most important things that goes hand in hand with good lighting. Good lighting and good audio, you can ensure that you have a quality video most times. So I'm just gonna pop this up on here. It's funny because I wasn't using this microphone for the whole summer because it was broken. Today I just rigged up a quick little fix for it if it wants to go on there. Okay, so now that I got my audio and my camera and my light ready to go, don't mind the mess around the room. You know, it's just how it is around here. I'm gonna move this bench over here, and this is gonna be the vlogging station right here. Just like this. We're gonna vlog to you. We're gonna vlog to me. So stay tuned. Oh man, I'm just debating whether I should smoke or not before the video. Need a beverage first. Damn it. Hey, having to change the milk bag. And there's no water. All I really want is some water right now, and there's none. So I have to drink some milk. Milk. You know. Alright, so now that I got my milk, I think I'm ready to start vlogging. And, oh shit, nigga in the dark again. Can't see me. Better smile. I'm just kidding. But yo, I'm right here. This is where I went to the wall and I had my laser eye surgery and I fell. Shit, it was like a month ago, but guess what? My eyes are doing better and I love having no glasses. Although I might look different, it feels good. It feels great not having glasses. I'm actually about ready to start vlogging here. What we're gonna talk about in this vlog is gonna be dreadlocks, obviously. 60 months. Shit, I guess if you wanna know the rest, you better stay tuned once again. And I'm gonna start this vlog right now. You haven't noticed I'm wearing my camera here and you're watching me film up there and you're probably like, what is this guy even doing? Filming himself, filming, and I'm just utilizing my double camera or some shit. I don't know. But it's Not Locs and I'm back here in 60 months. 60 months, 60th month since I've had these dreadlocks on my face, on me head. I guess you could say a little bit more adequately. And you know what? 60 months of having locks is a long time. And so my eyes are still a little dry from the surgery. And don't worry, my eyes are doing good. Might look a little different, but who cares? I feel free. And the number one reason why I got my eyes lasered was because just in case anything ever happens in the world, like a natural disaster or warfare or revolution, whatever it may be, you know, if there comes a time when there's a crisis and I lose my glasses within that crisis, I will be useless. Would not be able to save myself. So I figured it'd be a good investment to get my eyes lasered so I don't have to rely on an optician in the time of a crisis. Also, I can motorboat a lot better. True story, because when you motorboat with glasses, they get all smudgy and shit. Anyways, back to the dreadlocks. I think the next thing I wanted to talk about in this video was the fact that these locks have been freeforming since August. And you can see here in the top that I have a lot of frizzy hair, and I wonder if I can actually show you guys how much, like, I'm talking a lot, like, that's new growth, that's frizzy, and you might know from old videos how I used to be obsessed with, like, keeping these frizzy hairs in, and not having them out, because it would drive me nuts having frizzy hair, but now I'm, like, not caring at all about them, because I wanted to give my hair, like, some rest, because when you're taking in all the frizzy hair all the time, it's straying on your head, I realized. So I wanted to give it a break, and I just haven't been crochet hooking or nothing for the longest time. And it's interesting because there's some new growth at the back that is just like pure frizzies, but it won't dread. And I'm interested to see if that hair will dread without me doing anything to it. It's like this one right here. And look how long that is. Like, that's my new growth. You can check out, like, the length on that. Like, I don't think I will. It looks like a troll doll. You know, it sticks out everywhere. But even on the sides, too, you'll see just, like, mass amounts of frizzy hair that I'm not caring for. And I think the reason for this is because I'm at a new stage in my lock journey. When I first started my lock journey, I was always obsessed about having them neat. And now I'm kind of like past that stage of caring for the neatness of them, and more in getting in tune with, like, the health of my hair. And another reason why I decided to stop maintaining my locks is because of this spot right here. I don't know if it's just me, but this spot seems to be the only part of my head that seems to be showing a little bit more scalp than the rest. You know, gets you concerned, maybe it's a receding hairline or some shit, but it's probably not. But I did find out what it was, and it's the way that I don't want to call her a loctician, but my hair braider did my sections for me when I first got my locks done. What would have been my third time I got my locks did, because I didn't get the interlock single braid technique done until my third journey around, or my third attempt at starting my dreadlock journey. And I found out that it's all in the way that she sectioned the front. And I think that rather than having a direct part right in the middle of my head, which is how a lot of people will part their hair, I think that's a bad idea, because now my hair has learned to fall to the side, creating an ultimately, like, strain or, like, time. And as my locks get longer, they get heavier, and they're going to weigh down on the side more. And now it's created, like, a permanent part. If she had sectioned it differently, rather than having one and two with this part in the middle, if she would have split it up so, like, staggered three dreads here, so that there was an actual dread sectioned off in this part, and then another one here and here, I think it would have prevented this from happening. So I think it's very important, if you're going to section your dreads, to make sure you section them in a way that down the road, when they start to fall down from the weight, they don't fall awkwardly. And one way to avoid that is to not have a center part down the middle. If anything, have a dread right there in the middle, and then have dread beside it. Don't do the center part. I remember when I did a few girls' hair a couple years ago, I always made sure to section the front properly like that, because I remember something about my hair not being sectioned properly when I had it done. Of course, there's, you know, there's some YouTubers like my friend Margot Escargot. She just didn't section her hair at all. She just kind of let her hair go, and that does work as well. But, you know, if you're looking for ways to section your hair, stagger it at the front. And at the back, do the same thing, but I find at the back you can section it a little bit bigger than the front, just because it's usually more hair and it's a little bit thicker at the back. Which is funny for me, because if I could show you the back of my head right now, maybe I can do this. Something, I don't know, but the new growth of the back seems to be really slow compared to my new unmaintained growth at the front. In terms of these right here, frizzies coming up, the ones at the back are just like slowly going, and they are kind of locking. I really don't see a difference in how my hair is locking, freeforming. It just feels like my hair is growing out. It doesn't really feel like I have new dreads forming. I'd have to do something. I could crochet hook the new growth in, or I could just leave it. I don't know. This is the part now where I'm kind of like turning back to YouTube and the online community to figure out how I can keep my hair locking without interlocking and without really crochet hooking a hardcore. You know, I'd rather take the natural process at this point. That's about all I can say at this moment. I find that having frizzy hair is only an issue when you go to tie your dreads back, because when you tie them back, it's when the frizzies really start to come out. So I've been wearing my hair down a lot more. I do have a plethora of dry scalp right now, so tomorrow morning, first thing when I wake up, is I'm going to wash these motherfudging dreads, because they need to be washed. They need to be washed. And hope you guys have been checking out my new vlogs. As you can tell, I was in Vegas, and you can go check out the channel that they're on, Godass TV. I have another trip coming up. I'm going to Montreal. I have to go do some skating, you know, so stay tuned. I gotta stay active in the winter. People be hibernating in the snow, so I'm trying to rollerblade and snowboard as much as I can. Hey, I think that these, new growth here, this frizzy hair, can be formed into a dread itself. I'm not sure what to do with it, you know. But yo, check out the locks. Check out the new growth. Fuck the locks. This is the freeform shit up here. I don't even know what's going on with this, man. How am I gonna, look how fucking messy it is. What am I gonna do with all this? My hair type just won't freeform naturally. It'll be like afro locks. You guys ever seen afro locks before? It's like when your hair is like mostly afro, but it's nappy, so it locks. Like, that's how my hair would be if I were to grow freeform dreads fully. I'm really interested to see if I were to cut these and like just grow my hair and see how locks would turn out then. That'd be crazy. I'm not saying when I cut them, I'm just, you know, talking metaphorically. But you know, thanks for watching on these videos. This is the time that I need to ask you guys, what type of videos do you want to see from me out in 2014? And if you have any requests, of course you can leave them down below. And if you guys have any comments, make sure you leave those below. And if you guys have anything else, just, you know, holler. I'm around. Facebook, Instagram, YouTube, choop. So yeah, hope you guys enjoy. Hope you guys enjoy the rest of your night. If you haven't done it already, subscribe, hit that button, and yeah, warm hellos and good vibes from Canada, because it's cold as a mother here. Stay warm, stay toasty, stay vibing, stay locked, stay nappy, stay on not locs. See you guys out next time. Peace.